time. I climb the pine, it's a flower of flame. Hard to obtain. Hard to obtain. I climb the pine, it's a flower of flame. Hard to obtain. I climb the pine, it's a flower of flame. Hard to obtain. Hard to obtain. I climb the pine, it's a
delirious in a vein, mysterious in a dream. Caught short of slips, my flips forged with steam. Poor sort that spits with this impure thought. Your rods are sick and twist for new talks. I threw a fork, sidestep the bright sense with a new report.
Authentic, mate. Just some authentic shit. Just let's make some music, put that shit out and see how that shit goes, mate, you know? No more, no less. There was never any great fucking plans for it. I mean, I wouldn't kid myself thinking I was going to get on fucking television or radio was going to pick up any of my songs. But funnily enough, you know, media sort of got their hands on it. The Age made it their album of the week, EG. It got listed as one of their top 10 albums of the year at the end of the year. And for an independent, shitty little fucking rap record to sort of make the impressions on people all over the place that it did, then, you know, I was pretty surprised by that, man, because really it was just a dude fresh out of his teens, fucking coming up with a bunch of ideas, living his life at the time, mad alcoholic kid, fucking weed addict, fucking sex addict, rap addict, just fucking all that shit just coming together in one big fucking lump of flesh and fucking, that was that.
Album was like the capital for everything good, man. Like all the good graffiti writers, all the boys. It was just mad. It was everything. It was sort of a bit dangerous to be out there doing what we were doing, riding trains around and, you know, wearing nice sneakers and shit, but we did it anyway. We weren't soft kids, you know. We got out there and did it and fucking, it was a good scene, mate. It was difficult being like, especially MCs, not even so much for me because you would more sort of jump up at shows and shit. There'd be like 15 people at a show, and like staunch cunts too, like real staunch individuals at a show. And we'd be like there, we'd be like kids, mate. We were always the youngest out of the crowd, just hanging out, what he's doing, we're here too. Mike would come out, boom, you'd be on stage. And I'd fucking do the thing, mate, you know. It didn't matter who was there at the show either, I'm telling you, heads would be there, like, fuck, you can rap in front of these cunts, mate, you're crazy.
I actually remember first time I saw Brad was before I met him, and I was on a tram out the eastern suburbs area going to a mate's house, and Strutt was on the tram with his homeboys. You know, like, put it this way, man, Strutt looked like Eminem 10 years before Eminem did, and I'm talking about Eminem when you first saw him, you know what I'm saying? So Strutt had like fucking white hair, short with some fucking Georgetown shit on, bleached hair and shit, and he was fucking on the back of this tram mouthing off, man. And I didn't even know this kid then, but I went on to meet him about a day or two later, and I just remember sitting there and I was thinking, who's this kid, man? He was rapping, he was fucking busting verses to his homies, and it was I just thought, man, that kid's got a bit of dash, you know.
This is Taunts Decimation Recordings, H fucking G. You know, down here we fucking struck for the authentic reissue. Go fucking check it out, buy that shit. And drink.